That's the one thing we can bring as producers to the table. We have 30 years of horror movie experience. We know what you want. We know what makes you bored, because it bores us too. So we tried to give you a movie that would scare us and disturb us.
Montose.
And I remember all three of us when we first saw Fede's early, early cut.
Honda.
A cut that he would hate to even show us. We're like, oh, we're good. We were so relieved. We're like, he did it. We didn't even have to, like, you know, we're good little producers. If you do a good job and you turn in a good director's cut, we're not gonna, why are we gonna mess with it? And it tested extremely well. So our gift to Fede is don't micromanage him in editing. Let him do it. If he was able to put together something with no input from us that we really like, then just we focus on the things that we either want to keep true to the movie series or things that bugged us. But other than that, you know, this is a Fede movie. We got some very bad reviews. You know, an Atlanta paper called it the sickest of the sick, the first Evil Dead movie, where Sam Raimi took every bad idea he ever had and put it into a low-budget blender. Then you have the LA Times calls it an instant classic. So where's the truth? You know, is it a classic or is it the worst? The nature of the Evil Dead movies has always been excessive. And a lot of the entertainment is actually the excessive nature of it. You know, when we had our first public screening, the greatest thing that I experienced when lights came up, everyone was jibber-jabbering. And they were all excited. Because it's weird. The one thing we found, comedies can get an audience involved, and a good horror film can get an audience involved, where it's almost like adrenaline. It's like as you watch the movie and you're hanging onto the rails because you don't know what's gonna happen next. And there were women in the audience that just screamed in general because they were just too upset by just general things that were happening. You just hear randomness. You'd always see the ones that happen when something went boo, but there's other people who are like, this is just disturbing me. That's the nature of that type of entertainment. The more, the gore, the merrier was our tagline that we always loved joking with. And with a horror movie, you know, why not? Fede Álvarez met Sam Raimi in a series of meetings that he was having because he went crazy on the internet and a little short he did called Panic Attack went viral. And next thing you know, literally 3 weeks later, he's in Spielberg's office, you know, and he's meeting with everybody and he's getting in CAA as his agent now. And I can't get those guys on the phone, you know. But this guy, out of nowhere, through his cleverness, made this little special effects heavy short of robots attacking a city. Sam was one of his meetings. And so Sam was actually talking about developing that into a feature film. But then that got bogged down in classic Hollywood fashion into development hell. And Fede pitched the concept of an Evil Dead because he was a fan. And Sam was like, well, what would you do? What would your approach be? And he pitched his idea and it all seemed very logical. And then Sam got He contacted me and Rob Tappert and was like, should we take this seriously or not? We're like, well, people have been talking about getting another one of these movies. Let's give them one with better effects, better actors. Every actor in this movie is better than any of us combined in the first one, as far as just the ease and the comfort at which they are performers. All the special effects are better. The photography is better. It's just, it was a chance to not see the green garden hose that's spewing the blood, you know? That's all we wanted to do was take the modern day ability and have a decent budget and let people have it again. So it's my comfortable shoe analogy that you go to watch this movie, there's a book, the same nasty book, it's five kids, it's a cabin, and they're gonna have a bad long night. So that's all similar. So that's kind of roundabout path that led us to actually making this happen, because as long as the elements were going to be the same, we were interested. We didn't want to do something, you know, Evil Dead on Mars or something. This is very, when people watch this, the fathers in the audience will go, yeah, this is a lot like the first one, and the new kids won't have any idea. It'll just be a movie that's going to just freak them out. We also made a major decision to have none of the original character names in the movie. There's no Ash character. And that was a big issue with a lot of fans of, well, if Ash isn't in it, then it's not an Evil Dead movie. It's like, yeah, it is. It's just it's a different generation. And we don't want the same anything. I don't want some guy trying to imitate my overacting performance. You know, why bother? Leave the guy alone. So all the other actors now in this movie get to create their own thing. And Jane Levy, by the end of this, she's taking this movie, you know, by the shoulders, and she's screaming at it in the face. She's taking this movie over. So if people want to call her the new Ash, I say do it. She's earned it. Traditional Hollywood horror movies are a female protagonist running around and screaming. And so it's mostly female-oriented as far as the victims go. When Evil Dead came around, Sam Raimi's theory was, let's make a man scream like a woman so that it'll be, that's how much worse it's gonna be. That this guy's gonna run around screaming his head off, because he wanted to amp the horror up. And now this is actually a little more of a traditional throwback, and the little Super 8 movie we used to raise money for the first Evil Dead, called Within the Woods, had a female protagonist. So we've kind of gone back to the roots of the roots of the roots, in a way. So it's more traditional, but it's more how we started the original idea, was with a woman. We did get involved in casting. That's where I jumped in, because I'm like, okay, I gotta sit in that room with these people and ask them, you know, can you, like with Jane Levy, she got a funny look on her face, because I said, Jane, you know, we really want you, but have you ever been completely covered in special effects makeup? For hours. It takes 2 hours to put it on. You're gonna shoot for a minimum of 12 hours. It's gonna take an hour to take it off. So you got 15-hour days in that stuff for weeks. You ready? She gave me this look of like, yeah. But then when I finally saw her at a convention in New York City, it was the first time I saw her since the movie was over. And she gave me one of those looks of like, yeah, yeah. I sent an email to all the actors that we finally cast to like, look, here's what's gonna be coming your way. You won't make a movie like this probably for the rest of your career. You're gonna go back and work on other movies after this, and you're gonna go, oh, this is nothing. It feels like an old school horror movie to me. It feels like a throwback. And it's a very loving throwback, in that you have possessed monsters, but Fede did it with a different spin with them. It's not a digital extravaganza. It's mostly prosthetic makeup effects and things like that when they get possessed, and just, you know, they wear the kooky contact lenses.
Just lost an eyeball?
I just lost an eye.
To me, it just seems like it's from the 70s. It just seems like it, the way Fede did it. I don't know what time it is, I don't know what year it is, and I think it's all good. You want these movies to last into the future as long as they possibly can without getting horribly dated. And, you know, Sam, I remember, wanted things specifically in the Evil Dead movies that would always be around. And he said, there will always be blue work shirts. I want you in a heroic blue, Superman blue work shirt. Everyone has work shirts, they'll always be around, they'll never go out of style. And I want you in corduroy brown pants. And brown pants will never go out of style. And so that was his theory. But she read the script. But, you know, again, how can you envision what's gonna happen? I'm sure it was ingestion-friendly material that they used, but who likes to be vomited on? Sam Raimi hit me in the face with Alpo dog food. So I can't really feel sorry for Jessica, because by then she's been hit with some hypoallergenic you know, non-infectious, completely non-toxic. Sam didn't care. He's like, give me a... We literally went to the store and bought Alpo dog food. Because it just looked like you mixed it with fake blood, just hitching the face. It just looks like the inside of someone's skull. So, yeah, I get Alpo. So I'm not, again, I'm not sorry, Jessica, but you'll be all right.
Shut up.
And back on The Evil Dead, we were making head molds with plaster of Paris. This was stuff that heated up. And, you know, we ripped all the eyelashes out of our lead actress. As she leaned back, we put Vaseline on her face, straws up her nose, and poured plaster Paris on her face. And we gave her a piece of paper with a pencil. I guess it's the only way she could communicate. She starts writing like heating up, getting very lightheaded, you know, and it's her writing is getting how much longer. So to get it off, she had to lean forward and let the gravity suck it off of her face. And there were eyelashes embedded in the plaster of Paris. This is how our movie started. You know, this is the first movie. My record in a day was 4 head molds, 2 arm molds, and a complete body mold. You know, where it's just, you wish your mother never met your father by the end of it. This is why I send everyone in the movie an email, all the actors, of what you're gonna go through, because they not only went through a lot physically as before they get possessed, but then a number of them do get possessed, so they go from, you know, being a human pincushion after they've been attacked by a nail gun to being possessed. So it's just a bad double whammy for these kids.
Join us.
And so I think the world might be ready, hopefully, for a movie that is, it's a serious horror movie that takes itself seriously, which is why I want the warning on the box. I think people should know that they're getting into something that they need to be ready for. This isn't a jokey little horror movie you go on a little fun date with. You're gonna get it. You're gonna get both barrels, so you better like what you're going for. It's not false advertising. And we don't want false advertising. You know, we want people to know what they're getting into. It's got an R rating, so if you can go to an R-rated movie, you can see this movie. But there's R, and then there's R, and then there's our R, which is, it's gonna be R.